Welcome back to our main course, SFT BMD, class number 6. Last class, I told principle of moment and I explained how to find moment of a force about any required point. I told about the principle and also about the direction. Now is the time for examples. I will take two examples. See, so I need today's class and one more class, because I don't want to hurry. Today's class, I will take the example of an inclined force. The purpose is to understand the real concept of moment. Next class, I will consider a system of forces, the way it comes in case of beams when you go for SFD BMD. So, first example, I will mark a point here. Somewhere here, that's an inclined force. Say anything, 80 Newton, 80 kilonewton rather, because why? Actually, this example comes in steel structures, where in the bracket connection, you get inclined load. So useful for them. So I'll take 20 degrees, some angle. Now see, some point here. I'll take the point as A, B, this is contact point C. I want required, I'll write here, required to find moment of 80 kN load. See, instead of force, I'm calling load now. Load, see, about A. I already told you, throughout this course, I will insist, when you find moment, you should correctly decide about which point. Once you decide the moment about a point, then that perpendicular distance should be from that point to line of action of the force or load. So what you will do is about a, some distance should be given. See, this I will take some 3 meter for advantage for me, because if I take 3 and 4, inclined length will come 5. So little calculation easier. Okay, now I have got, see, two options. I'll tell you, option one is basic. Option two, using resolution. This is the best option, because in option one, you have to struggle and get the distance. But in option two, you get very easily. So after this example is over, now onwards further, not only here, anywhere, you go for resolution. But better understand the principle. See, so I'll go for option one, basic. So I'll put here option one. Option one, that is basic. By basic concept, what you require? See, from the point A, draw perpendicular, say, some name required, H, to, see, line of action, to save the time. In future, if I put LOA throughout this course, LOA means line of action of 80 kN load. See, I'll do one thing, I'll mark the force here. The load is here. From this is the point A, this is the point B, this is the point I'll take C. Okay. You have to extend this, this is 80 kN load. You have to extend this force now. But one problem comes. When you extend, doubt will come. Will the extended line will pass below A or above A? See here, this angle given is 20 degrees. If that is 20 degrees, this will be 70 degrees. So if I extend here this way, this angle will be 70 degrees. Now, you see, if I join this one, the light line, what is this angle? It is tan inverse of 4 divided by 3. Tan inverse of 4 divided by 3 is 53.13 degrees. I know that answer, standard it is. So surely, since it is 70, it will come this way. after this example is completely over, I will give an exercise for you where this angle, if it is the same example, is less than 70, less than 53.13. So then, see, when you go this way, it will cut somewhere here. It will cut somewhere here. In that case, principle is same, but construction will slightly change. So I will write the solution in the board, no explanation. Why? That much dedication and effort you have to put. Briefly, I will write solution here. That is before recording only, I will write solution and start. And then rub immediately. So you take the screenshot or pause it and note down and solve. See now. So from A, it will be perpendicular. See, it's a perpendicular now. Now see, I extend this line. This is called H, perpendicular H. Extend this line. If this is 70 degrees, see, this will be 20 degrees, guaranteed. You don't have to worry. Now, A, I'll take this point as A, B, C, say D and E, new names. I want H. If I want H, I will use this triangle, see, this triangle. So you can write sine 20 equal to, this is 90 degrees, this is hypotenuse. So equal to H divided by A, D. Therefore, to get H, now you require AD. See, you already know B to A is 4 meter. 4 meter. This is 3 meter. Now, you require A to D. For that one, you find what is this full distance first. Say, I will call this as some Y. Some vertical distance Y. So, what you do is to get AD, to get AD, first consider a triangle DBC. DBC means this full triangle. So from here, we have, from here if you see, tan 20 equal to BC divided by BD. BC is already known 3 meter. Therefore, you get the value of BD. BD will come 3 divided by tan 20. 8.2424 meter BD. Once you get BD, therefore your AD will be equal to, see, A to D will be equal to whatever is your BD minus 4 meter. So BD is already known, substitute there, you get 4.2424 meter. Now, substituting, you get the value of which one? H. How? Sine 20 equal to, because, come back here, equal to H divided by AD is 4.2424. You get the value of H. H will come in meter.
4.2424.
meter. Actually, 1.45098 is there. So, see, 1.450986. I will tell you why I am telling. I will round off to third decimal, sufficient. 1.45 meter. Therefore, moment of 80 kN load about A equal to, see here once again, I already wrote it. I will write once again now, see. Moment about A. A will be equal to 80 is the load into from A to the line of action of the load, perpendicular distance is H. into H. Substitute H equal to 1.451, sufficient, equal to 80 into 1.451. And final answer, you get 116.08 kilonewton meter. And very important, you require direction. See here. I already told, not required. If I want moment about A, I'll hold here. Apply this load. See, it will rotate in clockwise direction. This is the answer. This is our option 1, where we extended the line of action of the load and drop, we considered a perpendicular from the point about which you require moment to the line of action of the load and multiplied the magnitude of the load with that perpendicular distance. This is the basic concept or as per definition of moment. Now, I will go to option 2, that is resolution. Remember, very, very powerful and very important for you. Now, after seeing that the board is clean or made ready, I'll rub this one now. This also I'll rub, or I'll write the answer here. See, you may require 100, even this also I can remove. Let it be there, 116.08 clockwise you got. Somewhere here, I will give example where this force will be something like this and cuts here. So that one you take exercise and solve, and then later check the value by resolution. Okay, over. We will continue. Consider option 2. That is resolution. Option 2 is not resolution. Option 2 is finding the moment by resolving the forces. See, consider 80 kilonewton force is like this. Last class and earlier class, I thoroughly explained resolution. So I won't waste too much time now. Draw or consider x direction. See, this is x direction. Horizontal, you will take. Angle made by the force with what? Vertical is given 20 degrees. I already told you. No, don't consider this angle. You better consider this angle. And also, not this angle or not this angle. I told you what mistake will happen if you take angle more than 90 degrees. I told consider the angle with nearest horizontal. This is 70 degrees. So, now 70 degrees and 80 kilonewton, we are considering. We are not considering 20 degrees. So now see, 80 kN force to the point C, it is acting. 80 kN force, see, this way. We'll have vertically downward component and horizontally left component. This also I explained earlier. So equal to one vertically downward component and left side component to the point C. This is component equal to 80 into cos 70, 80 into sin 70. See, I told you last time, after so much of thorough explanation, in future, I am not going to waste every time to tell x component is cos, y component is sin. That already I told you last time. So you should go through all the previous classes, be fully thorough and continue anytime. Never attend or start studying from an intermediate class, right from first class, completely for your benefit. kN. This is 75.175 kN. This is resolution. Now, you can replace this force by these two components. So now I will do one thing. I will mark the point A here. A. See. Through this point, I am replacing this force by a vertically downward force of 75.175 kN and a horizontal force this way or load of how much? 27.362 kilonewton. Remember, this distance is 3 meter. This height is 4 meter. You can see from the figure sketch only there, 4 meter. Oh. Okay. Now, we want moment about A. See, I told moment about A required. Therefore, moment of 80 kilonewton load about A equal to what? Algebraic sum of moments of its components about A. Remember, this is based on the most powerful principle in engineering mechanics, for that matter, most powerful principle in structure engineering, which comes in engineering mechanics. Usually in my classroom, I will ask, what is this principle? Some will tell, those who are regular and dedicated, some will tell, sir, we don't know. Okay, left their choice. Weyrig-Nose theorem. At least know it now. Weyrig-Nose theorem. So now, algebraic sum of moments of its components about A. Now, equal to, see, now, when you find algebraic sum, you require sign convention. Very important. You require sign convention. So when you go for a sign convention, for a moment, either clockwise or anti-clockwise, completely your choice. In our country, that is my country, India, we usually consider clockwise positive. But in Western countries, I observed, they consider anti-clockwise positive. So if any viewer here is outside, is from that side, you consider anti-clockwise, no problem. I will consider both here to understand thoroughly and so that you understand one more principle today. See, I will take about A equal to, in the bracket I will write clockwise positive. Okay, my choice. I will take clockwise positive. So start. Stand at A. This I am insisting from right from the last class. Now I will not tell every time, I will not tell at A, not stand at A. Consider the point A, put the finger here. See, 75.175 is a force this way. If the force is this way, perpendicular is like this. This also I thoroughly explained last time. So, 75.175 multiplied by 3. See, clockwise. See, this way. So, clockwise means plus your right. Plus 75.175 into 3. Okay, now 27.362. Next force multiplied by, see, this way. Now see how naturally I am shifting now. See, 27.362 into this distance, 4. This will be in anti-clockwise direction. Since you took clockwise positive, later, before SFD, BMD, or before starting the numericals, plenty of examples, one class, I will completely clear whatever difficulty is there for you regarding sign. Not whatever difficulty. I know majority of people get confused about sign convention. Sometimes a sign convention has no effect on the answer. Sometimes it has effect on the answer. In equilibrium, sign convention has no effect on the answer. But when you find SF and BM, sign convention has effect on the answer. You don't worry now. Everything, I am there to clarify all doubts and make it crystal clear for you, provided, as I told, dedication from your side. And going through class completely, not like entertainment. Therefore, this will be minus. Why? Because it is anti-clockwise, I might minus. Now, you should write the answer with sign. So, I'll calculate. Actually, I don't have to calculate because, see, I know the answer. First of all, I'm calculating only because what?
of the answer, I won't tell you. Into 3 minus 27.362 into 4. I am getting 116 positive, very important, positive. 116.077. I got not 8 earlier because I rounded off 1.450986 to 1.451. If I have rounded, taken little more number, lesser number, I would have got same answer. So I will write the answer for second decimal. That is 116.08 kilonewton meter. Okay, now, whenever you find something based on sign convention, you have to write the result without sign convention. See, that is, I'll tell you what is the meaning. That is, moment of 80 kilonewton load about A is, I took clockwise positive. Answer came positive. That means the moment is in the same direction as my sign convention. Therefore, no sign now. 116.08 kilonewton meter in clockwise direction. This is the result or final verdict. Okay. It's completely over. Now, I will do one thing. I will now once again start from here. See, when you write, make a fair copy, this much first you have to write. Now, once again, you start from here. Moment of same principle, instead of clockwise positive, suppose you consider anti-clockwise positive. No problem. See, what happens? Then, about A if you consider, see, here again. 75.175 into 3 is clockwise. Since you take anti-clockwise positive, this is minus. Then, 27.362 into 4 is anti-clockwise. As per sign, it will become plus. When you calculate, it will become minus 116.08. Now, result. We considered the moment in anti-clockwise direction. But result came negative. Negative sign indicates that what direction you considered here, the result is not in that direction, it is in opposite direction. Opposite to anti-clockwise is clockwise. So, final verdict, moment of 80 kN load about A is 116.08, no sign now. Instead of anti-clockwise, it is clockwise. That means, irrespective of your sign convention, for any problem, solution is unique. Your sign convention will not change the final result. So therefore, here you can make out, sign convention has effect. Sign convention has effect. But when you go to equilibrium, you will be knowing later, once I will take clockwise positive, result will come positive. Then I will take anti-clockwise positive. Then also result will come positive. So that positive will be having no link to that clockwise positive, anti-clockwise positive. That positive sign will indicate something else. I will clarify when I go there. Okay, now this is over. So we completed moment of this force about the point A in two different options, by two different options, and both the options answer came same. For that matter, in my class, you do 1,000 options, all 1,000 times answer will come same. I told confidence. Okay, now what I will do is that exercise I will write here. I first told I will write exercise problem. I forgot, no problem. Now so I will make the board ready. I will write the exercise here. I will give brief solution and very brief explanation so that it is for you to continue and get the answer. I wrote the question here with brief solution. These all already explained in the previous example. So you should see that one and write it. Thoroughly work out this one. See, as I told, this is 60 degrees. This angle will be 30 degrees, whereas if I join these two, see these two points, this angle will be 53.13 degrees. So this force will cut somewhere here. So slight changes in the trigonometric calculations, get the answer and solve once by option one, then by option two, get the answer.
Now, with this one, today's class is over. Next class, that is class number 7, I will consider multiple force system.
I'll tell you how it is, but I don't want right here because this it will spoil this. Suppose you want to take screenshot, you can take earlier only, no problem. See,
I'll take a system with so many forces. Maybe I'll put some upward force also. And then we'll explain you how to find moment of this force system about different points very thoroughly, so that when you go to SFD BMD, you will have no problem for finding that is called support reaction, and also later for finding bending moment and shear force. Okay, I'll wind up the class now. But before winding up the class, one small important message for you. See, settings, writing solution on the board, and then telling this exercise. I think it is better, instead of that way, to give it separately. So, as I told earlier, I am planning to prepare a notes for our course to make the course really perfect. The notes will contain everything, what all told in the class, so many principles will be there, and also plenty of exercises for those who are serious and knowledge oriented. But to put that much effort, it requires a lot of effort. I have got a lot of commitments. Daily, I take more than 5-6 hours of class. And this age, taking 5-6 hours is not an easy job. But I always work hard in the educational field. I do not bother about my age for that matter. So now to prepare the notes and upload, I can upload in Google Drive and give the link for you in the description box so that you can easily download. I should be having good inspiration or motivation. See, for anything, if you want to give education to public in general, there should be motivation for the person to give it. I will get motivation or inspiration when I come to know that my classes are useful for many, many people. I do not want my classes to be used only in our country, India. I want it outside also. That is, instead of local, I prefer to go to global. Therefore, if you are feeling my class is really useful and you are getting very good knowledge, then from your side, you should see that to continue the classes with the same effort and systematic way, or to give motivation to me, you spread the news or pass on the information about the class to friends known to you, or in the groups, etc., or to the people who are interested in structural education. See that my class will reach maximum possible people. Then only I will have the satisfaction. See, for a teacher, nothing will be more satisfactory and or will give more pleasure than knowing that what he teaches is used by many, many people, and so many are getting knowledge because of his teaching. That is the topmost priority for a teacher. Financial matter is secondary. Throughout my profession of education, my first preference was, and now and will be in future, education, not the other one. The other one required, no doubt, but no. Topmost priority will be for education or knowledge oriented. Okay, sufficient. So you can carry out the instruction given just now, and I will continue now in class number 7, that is next class. Okay, thank you all.